Hey guys, welcome back. So today's look is a earthy metal look. It's a combination of brown shadows and a metal colored liner. I hope you enjoy. So I've already applied my foundation and brows, and now I'm going to go in with a blending brush and just start to create the shape. I'm using a warmer tone eyeshadow as usual. All of the eyeshadows that I'm using today are more of a golden brown with a little bit of that gold sparkly reflect. Now I'm going to go in with Muse from my Urban Decay palette. It's from the Vice palette, I believe, the first one. And I'm just going to deepen that crease. This brown is more of a reddish brown. I thought it would be perfect for this. It's really important to not take it any further than the crease. It'll look way too messy. Whenever I want a color to really pop, I always base it, especially if it's a sparkly color. Sparkly colors always end up being a little bit more translucent. So I based that one just so that way you could see more of that gunmetal color. I always like to build up on the crease, so I just keep going in there and deepening it. I'll do, you know, the pop of color on my lid and then go back in again with a crease color just to make sure that that really stands out. With a clean blending brush, I'm just going to buff out those edges so that way it's nice and smooth and looks really blown out. This look was inspired by two different eyeliners, actually. One of which is this one. It is the Kat Von D ink liner in the color Woolf. It is a really amazing, hard to describe color. I know that it's a little bit hard to see too, but this is my first time using the colored liners from this line, and I have to say they're amazing. Is you at 2 keys or 10 roof? Turn up, we on Tiller, we just getting loose. Baby, I'm low key feeling you. So I know I've talked a lot about the Age Rewind concealer from Maybelline. I got a new color, and this one is in the color Honey. It's a little bit deeper. I thought that I would try it. I think it's perfect for girls that are a little bit more tan like myself. It's not too light. You know, I've talked about it being too light before, how that can be a total disaster. This one's really nice. Since this color isn't super light, I decided to go ahead and contour my nose with it, which is something I don't normally do with concealer because it ends up looking like I have this white mask on. But this one's more natural, so I thought I'd give it a try. I wanted more of a cat eye effect, so I brought the liner down towards my nose and then again at the bottom of my eye to create a nice point. The second eyeliner I was inspired by came in my Ipsy bag by The Balm Cosmetics, and it's Mr. Right Now in the color Jack. It's a really creamy color. I thought it would be perfect for underneath the eyes to kind of smoke it out. My normal contour with the Anastasia palette and my Morphe brush. But on a side note, these facial expressions and position and pulling of my skin is really intense. Okay, for my nose contour, I like to use a stiffer brush to create those lines. I try to make it as straight as possible. So once those are on, I'm going to blend them out. And then I always like to go back in after that's done and create two little lines right at the tip of my nose. It makes that button nose effect, and it's my favorite. Don't think about you just because I ain't spoken about you. I'd ask you how you feel, but already know I won't get it out you. You probably tell your friends. These are luster drops from MAC. They're pretty much just a liquid highlighter. MAC doesn't make these anymore, but you can use any liquid highlighter for this particular look. I didn't want an actual blush for this look. I wanted more of a bronzy, glowy look to go along with those earth tones. This is Warm Soul from MAC. And because apparently two highlighters was not enough, Trace Gold from MAC. It says it's a blush. I don't believe it's a blush. I think it's a highlighter, but you can decide. I'm actually really excited about this part. I'm using Cork by MAC to overline my lips just a tad and change the shape just to make them a little bit more rounded instead of the normal pointy heart shape that they are. I went with Style in Sepia from MAC for my lipstick. It was a nice combination of brown and gray. I'm just gonna go in and re-round the edges of my lips towards the top and again through the bottom, just to make sure that that shape is staying. Then when all of that is done, I'm gonna go in with a lip gloss from MAC as well. It is called No Apology. It's a nice sparkly color. I know it looks dark, but it really isn't in real life. Alright guys, that does it for this video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you next time. But in the meantime, here's all my extra unnecessary behavior. Bye!
Hello you guys, welcome to Cruise TV, and today I'm going to be talking about Shopkins. Stay tuned! Bye! And these are all my Shopkins right here. Hope you like it. Here's this camera. And I really like it because it's so cute and has a little handle. And that's all I like. See you next time. Bye.